From DailyDoseOfWeirdNews.com, I'm Darren Marlar, and this is your Daily Dose of Weird News. If you're already an official weirdo, please share this video on Facebook, Twitter, Reddit, and other social media to help get the word out. If you'd like to become an official weirdo, simply click that subscribe button, and while you're at it, click that like button to let the world know that you are a weirdo. Tom Cruise was injured on set in London yesterday while filming a stunt for Mission Impossible 6. In a video clip, Cruise can be seen leaping off a platform onto the roof of a building, but coming up short and crashing into the side of the building instead of landing on top of it. The impossible part of this mission is Tom's insurance company continuing to cover him doing his own stunts despite the fact that he's 55 years old. The world's oldest man has died at 113. You know, on second thought, maybe having everybody jump out from behind furniture and yell surprise at his last birthday party wasn't such a good idea. NBC is going to try a reboot of the Munsters. Why do we need a bunch of monsters and heavy makeup on another show? We already have The View. Your grandparents could soon be getting some help from Uber. Thanks to a new partnership between London-based geriatrics startup Cira and the transportation giant Uber, the elderly portion of the UK's population will soon be able to make their way home from the hospital with greater ease thanks to rides from Uber and its drivers, who are to be especially trained to assist people with disabilities. To indicate to other drivers that they are carrying an elderly person, the Uber driver will be required to drive at all times at 10 miles per hour under the limit with the blinker on the entire way. A study says that 2/3 of American kids can't find North Korea on a map. The remaining third wanted a hint by asking what state it was in. Seahawks defensive end Michael Bennett sat with a towel over his head during the national anthem before his team took on the LA Chargers in the preseason opener for both teams at the StubHub Center. Bennett's action came a day after his former teammate, running back Marshawn Lynch, did something similar before the Raiders' exhibition opener on the road Saturday against the Arizona Cardinals. Bennett told reporters after his team's 48-17 win that he hopes this stance will cause others to go out and get involved in changing their community. He says he intends to continue to sit during the national anthem. Well, you know, this did wonders for Colin Kaepernick's career. He is so in demand, Spike Lee has had to come to his side to try and find the guy a job. So yeah, feel free to follow in his footsteps, dork brains. Tiger Woods has pleaded not guilty to DUI and will enter a diversion program. Of all people, you'd think Tiger Woods would know when to use a different driver. Remember Play-Doh? In February, Hasbro, the toy giant that owns the putty, filed paperwork to trademark the product's smell. According to the filing, it's a unique scent formed through the combination of a sweet, slightly musky, vanilla-like fragrance with slight overtones of cherry and the natural smell of a salted wheat-based dough. They want to trademark the smell of Play-Doh. You know they have plans for it, right? I mean, if my wife comes home with Play-Doh perfume, we're going to have words. A man in China had more than 50 maggots removed from a rotting open wound in the back of his head. Surgeons operated on the 75-year-old patient after he'd scratched open a wart on the back of his head days earlier. Wow. You know, maybe mom wasn't exaggerating when she said to stop scratching. Taco Bell certainly is not afraid of launching menu items that pack a seriously flavor-packed punch, but their latest burrito is quite the firecracker. The new firecracker burrito comes in two varieties, cheesy or spicy, and it's stuffed with rice, nacho cheese, sour cream, beef, and red tortilla strips. For an additional 20 cents, you can get a packet of spicy cayenne-popping crystals added to your burrito. Cayenne-popping crystals. What are they adding, pop rocks now? A Swedish scientist has developed a high-tech solution for what she considers an environmentally friendly burial. The ingenious machine will take your lifeless corpse and turn you into clean and useful compost within a matter of months. Swedish biologist Susan Wee-Massak spent 3 years making what is perhaps the most green crematorium on Earth. The invention freezes the dearly departed's body, then vibrates their body into dust, then pops them into a sack of potatoes. Seriously, the starch in the potatoes helps the dust become compost and ready to help something else grow tall and green on Earth. Or you could just have yourself buried in a pine box and also turn into soil. without the exorbitant and ridiculous expense. But what fun would that be? For all the jokes made about fruitcake, it may just be the food that can survive any environment. Conservationists have discovered a 100-year-old fruitcake in the Antarctic, of all places. And apparently it looks and smells almost edible. Made by Huntley and Palmers, the fruitcake is described as being in excellent condition and still wrapped in paper. In fact, the cake itself held up better than the tin box it was kept in, which is deteriorating. The cake is believed to have been brought to the region by British explorer Robert Falcon Scott. Scott and his party successfully made it to the South Pole on the Terra Nova expedition from 1910 to 1913, but all five died on the return journey to base camp. Lizzie Meek of the conservation group said it's an ideal high-energy food for Antarctic conditions and is still a favorite item on modern trips to the ice. So, when giving somebody a fruitcake this coming December, just know you're giving them a forever food. You fall in love and marry for many reasons – a fabulous physique, a great sense of humor, an abiding trust. But did you know that you're also attracted to his or her bachelor's degree? One of the traits that attracts us to our mates is educational achievement. It turns out that our educational DNA is one of the sparks that helps light the romantic fire. British researchers have concluded that our genes drive us to a relationship with someone who has a similar level of education. Translation: smart, highly educated people will marry each other and produce children who are also smart and highly educated. My neighbor's kids are going to be so stupid. Pharrell Williams got stuck in an elevator for 30 minutes last week in Los Angeles. No word on whether he was happy about it or not. Stress can make you fat. Why? It's biological. When your life is filled with stress and anxiety, your body produces high levels of the stress hormone cortisol. And British researchers have discovered there is a link between cortisol and excess weight. In fact, I got on the scale this morning, and obviously I am a lot more stressed than I thought. Sean Spicer has let it be known he's interested in a Saturday Night Live appearance. Worked for Trump, willing to go on SNL, obviously a glutton for punishment. This episode's brought to you by the audiobook True Tales of Haunted Places by G. Michael Vasey, narrated by Darren Marlar. Anywhere and anything can be haunted, and many people from all walks of life experience strange things in surprising locations. As you'll discover, the prettiest of places, the most innocent of places, and the most unexpected places can be filled with supernatural forces and pure demonic malevolence. Haunted places, churches, hospitals, forests, the workplace, and more. Horrifying true tales of ghosts, demons, poltergeists, and the paranormal. Come and be chilled by people's creepy experiences with the supernatural in ordinary, everyday places. Warning: listening to this book may increase nervousness. Hear a free sample and support Marlar House by downloading the audiobook for yourself at marlarhouse.com. Be sure to like this video and subscribe to the channel if you want to see more. Be sure to click that notification bell too, so you'll be notified when I post new videos. Find even more weird news that I didn't have time for at DailyDoseOfWeirdNews.com. I'm Darren Marlar, and I'll see you next time, weirdos.